Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Daily Reading. This is your daily message for tomorrow, Wednesday, July 13th, 2022. For all signs that may be watching. And this is a reading for the collective, so it may not resonate with you specifically. As I always say, for the most accurate reading with the most accurate outcome, please come get a personal private tarot reading from either me or your favorite tarot reader out there. Guys, this is the last reading in this series of seven daily messages. I will be resuming the weekly forecast for next week, so you'll be getting those for sure. Probably by the 17th, I'll release them. So those weekly forecasts will come out for the 18th through the 24th. So stay subscribed to my channel. You don't want to miss those. Big week ahead, so everyone needs to watch their sign. This reading is for the collective, so like I always say, I'll call out the signs as I see them. For your reading today, we are using Game of Thrones tarot deck, otherwise known as GOT tarot. All right. Oracle messages, we're using this deck here. This is the Threads of Fate Oracle Shadow Edition. You can visit them at www.threadsoffate.com or at the Threads of Fate. Blair Porter and Britt June are the authors, designers of this deck. So for more information, please visit them. Oops, there's also a little QR code here. If you want to take a screenshot of that, you might be able to get some more information like the guidebook. This box here, publisher is copyright 2017 Home Box Office Incorporated. All right, you can visit them at chroniclebooks.com. www.chroniclebooks.com is the publisher. So for more information, please visit Chronicle Books. Okay. Let's put that over here so I know that I'm ready today. Okay. All right, Spirit. Provide for us messages and energies for the collective for tomorrow, the 13th of July, 2022, for all signs that may be watching. What are the most important messages and energies you want to share with the collective for tomorrow, Spirit? I am getting the number 5. So there could be some sort of conflict, attack, dispute. I'm hearing conflict of interest. This could also be a verbal or physical attack going on for someone in the collective. Now they're saying arm yourself, guard yourself, or something about arms. I'm hearing an arms race or something about a race here. Let's see. 7 of Spears reversed. Leo's energy. 3 of Coins reversed. Capricorn's energy. Wheel of Fortune reversed. Jupiter. Okay, so Sagittarius. Also, Jupiter is in Aries right now. So that could resonate with a with you if you have this placement or if you are an Aries. We have the Emperor, Aries, Taurus, Leo under the deck here. Divine masculine energy coming through. That is the underlying theme or challenge of tomorrow, is this Emperor card here. So the Emperor is the king of all kings. He is, like, you know, he is the one that is the boss, the one that's in charge here. This is someone that does not allow their emotions to affect their behavior. This is someone who basically logic and reason over emotions. That's the name of the game here. Also, we have someone that is in his divine masculine energy. This is someone who has a very commanding presence, very controlled presence, but also maybe a very controlling person. Not emotional, really all about business, this person is. So you could be dealing with someone like this tomorrow, or this is you. Again, the signs we have, Taurus, Leo, they're saying Aquarius or Sagittarius, but Taurus, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Capricorn, Leo. So someone is under attack here, and the Seven of Spears reversed indicates someone is going to have to back down, back away, or back off. Okay, so this is someone letting down their guard. It also can indicate someone here who is defenseless. So this could be someone that does not have spiritual protection around them or protection, or they're under attack here and it looks like they do not have the upper hand. Could be a Leo. Three of Coins reverses, people are not working together. They're, if we're aligning, committing, and building on the same foundation here, then this Three of Coins would be in the upright position, but it is not. It is reversed. So when it comes to work, employment, groups of people, friends, possibly a team situation, people are not on the same page here. If this is a third-party situation, it's not working out. And by third party, I mean two, three people or more working together in some sort of a group situation here. Friends, coworkers, usually this card, this is the apprentice card, so it has to do with employment. Someone's job could not be going well tomorrow. And the Wheel of Fortune in reverse is a reverse of fortune. So you can expect ongoing setbacks, delays, and confusion. This could also indicate a retrograde type of situation. They're saying don't push your luck, and also this could be a very unfortunate or bad luck day for those who are employed, those who have to work with others, build with others. I'm feeling like something is not working well. People are not working well together. Also, someone could find themselves under attack or feel like they're being a, I don't see a victim situation, but I do feel like someone's going to have to back down, back away here. There's too much opposition at this time. They're saying you will not win, you will not get ahead, you will not succeed in this endeavor. If we add everything up here, this is a four. We have a seven, a three, so 10, 13. And we have another 10 here, so 23, which reduces to a five. Like I said, I called it five. I called the number five. For tomorrow, the Five of Swords, there's some sort of an attack or dispute going on. This could be a physical or verbal attack on someone's person tomorrow. This is a good day if you do need to carry a weapon. I'm not suggesting that you do. And of course, there are laws in other states and so forth. And we, in America, we have our share of controversy regarding this. But I would not be going into any kind of dark alley here alone. I would not be putting yourself in the way of danger. Stay away from conflict because it will find you very easily if you're not careful, especially if you are. This could be an employment situation. I'm also seeing something going on with an oil rig or maybe something going on in the oil industry. Because to me, this could also be some kind of a water tower, oil rig, pumping station. You know, this reminds me of a picture, an image I looked at the other day. I was on my newsfeed. I see a lot of random stuff in my newsfeed, but I mean, as do most people, who doesn't get like random stuff in their newsfeed? Like, I didn't know I needed to know that there were 13 and a half billion, we're 13 and a half billion years away in terms of this new Webb Hubble telescope image. 13 and a half billion years old is the universe. I did not know that, but I guess things like this pop in your newsfeed. So this could be something that pops up in your newsfeed tomorrow. Back to what I was saying. What was the image that I saw? Not that you care. I care. It was like someone was reopening a restaurant or fixing something. Oh, shoot. This was like a familiar place to me. Where they were fixing. It was an odd image. I don't recall what it was of. This could also be happening in a brewery of some kind. I don't know. I'm getting like Steelworks Brewery. There's some kind of a contraption here at the center of this reading. I feel strongly this is happening in a workplace, a work environment. If you're going into work tomorrow, you could find that there are issues with people not doing their job, people's shifts, they're not coming in on time. Yeah, it's not moving in a positive direction. This could also be a break and entry situation. Someone may have broken in here, or there's the alarms are not going off, or someone could find themselves cornered. Okay, if you happen to work in a military environment, there could be someone here. This could be your boss, your employer, someone in authority here could, I don't know. I'm also hearing someone's getting pinned for something that they did not do. So it could be someone is going to be scapegoated tomorrow. Make sure it's not you. How to get out of a scapegoating situation. If I knew, I would tell you, because sometimes these things happen, right? And we're not prepared for them to happen. Heck, this could happen to me tomorrow. So they're saying be on guard. And also, if you are a guard, then do your job and be prepared to do your job tomorrow, whatever kind of guard you are. Okay. So let's see. What is the overall advice for this reading for tomorrow? We have the universe, we have destruction, and we have ancestors. Well, there is something destructive happening here. This is happening in the world. The ancestors are coming through tomorrow. Let's get some more information on these cards. Let's see what they say. I will read briefly from the book here. And of course, you can follow along if you like. So let's see, what does the universe card say? Oh, I see the one for destruction. The universe. So this card asks you to fully trust that there is a plan for you and that you have the support of the unseen. There are forces at play much larger than you could imagine. Surrender to that which you cannot control and trust in the idea that spirit is always orchestrating what is most needed. This card may come at a time when a cycle or trial is also coming to a close. Phrase any what-if questions in a positive way. What if this is going to be okay? What if this is exactly as it should be? All right. I'm guessing that's it. Okay, I don't see the rest of it. All right, so let's move on to the destruction here. I saw that on the other side. At some point, I'm going to have to go through and connect these paragraphs together because they're all disjointed. This card indicates that a choice must be made. It asks you what needs to die today. Maybe it is a limiting belief, an old inherited pattern, or a toxic relationship. Whatever it is, it is time to let go. It's time to let it go. Sometimes, once we identify what needs to go, it slips easily from us. Other times, it is a slow cycle of releasing and then loosening the grip of our attachment. Be kind to yourself in this process. We establish attachments to things that do not serve us, but knowing something doesn't serve us does not mean it is easy to let it go, especially if it has become a part of our identity. This process requires patience, practice, and self-compassion. And last but not least, we have the Ancestors card here. Ancestors come through. Someone has ancestors around them tomorrow. I feel like you are being backed and supported by the universe here. Unfortunately, if you are not letting go, that is when you're having trouble letting go of attachments. That's when the Wheel of Fortune is going to start spinning in reverse to let you know that pushing any further is not going to get you there faster. Yeah, I'm just trying to find the card here. Sorry. Oh, how I hate this pamphlet. Here we go, Ancestors. This card is encouraging you to deepen your relationship with your ancestors and bring whatever you want guidance on to them. If you have not already done so, making an altar just to your ancestors is a good way to begin. You can ask them what they want as offerings and put pictures, if you have them, or symbols of them on it as well. It may be a good idea to take a pilgrimage, if possible, to the places they once lived. If not, learn as much as you can about them and where they came from. Okay. So do you know where your ancestors came from? You could also do an altar to them or possibly wear something that they, or hold something in your hand, or keep some possession near you where it's safe though. Like for example, a pocket watch or some tags or something like that, or a pin, jewelry, maybe a photograph. And call on them for guidance and protection. You can light a candle. If something is being destructed tomorrow in your life or in your world, it's because you had an unhealthy attachment to it in the first place and it's no longer serving you. So you're being supported by the universe in your efforts to surrender and to let go. I could be speaking to a divine masculine tomorrow, or someone that has those signs that I mentioned before, Leo, Capricorn, Sagittarius, Aries, Taurus. So this is what I have for you guys tomorrow. Thank you for tuning in. This is your daily reading.